Hi, welcome to Sunil Maths Tutorial Online Classes Real Analysis Infinite Series 2. First, we see some results. The first one is, if summation un converges to a real number L belongs to capital R, then summation CUN converges to CL, comma, where C not equals to 0. If summation UN converges to L belongs to capital R, then summation CUN converges to CL, where C not equals to 0. And thus, let us see second result. If summation UN converges to L, comma, summation Vn converges to L dash, and P, comma, Q are any two real numbers, then summation Pun plus Qvn converges to PL plus QL dash. Observe that summation UN converges to L, summation VN converges to L dash, and P, comma, Q belongs to capital R, real numbers. Then summation PUN plus QVN converges to PL plus QL dash. If summation UN diverges, comma, C belongs to capital R, then summation CUN is also diverges. Observe that if summation UN diverges and C is any real number, then summation CUN is also diverges. This CUN means a scalar multiple of UN with C. And fourth one, summation UN, comma, summation VN are divergent series, then their sum, summation UN plus VN is also divergent. Observe these four properties. You remember these. Summation UN converges to L belongs to R, then summation CUN converges to CL, where C not equals to 0. If summation UN converges to L and summation VN converges to L dash, where P, comma, Q belongs to R, then summation PUN plus QVN converges to PL plus QL dash. If summation UN diverges, comma, C belongs to R, then summation CUN is also diverges. If summation UN, comma, summation VN are divergent series, then summation UN plus VN is also a divergent series. We prove a theorem which is known as nth term test. Theorem number 2. Nth term test. Next theorem. Which is known as nth term test. The statement of this theorem is, if summation UN converges, if summation UN converges, then limit n tends to infinity, UN is equals to 0. If summation UN converges, then limit n tends to infinity, UN is equals to 0. Let us prove this theorem, one of the important one, which is also known as nth term test. This is a necessary condition for an infinite series to be convergent. Let us say summation UN is convergent. Summation UN is convergent to a real number. Convergent to a real number L belongs to capital R. Right. define Sn be the nth partial sum. Sn be the nth partial sum of summation un. If Sn be the nth partial sum of summation un, then Sn is equals to u1 plus u2 plus and so on plus un, comma n belongs to z plus. Since summation un converges to L, summation un converges to L, then limit n tends to infinity, Sn also equivalent to L. Now write Sn minus 1. Sn is equals to sum of the n terms. Sn minus 1 is equals to sum of the first n minus 1 terms. Comma n belongs to z plus. Since limit n tends to infinity, Sn is equals to L, then limit n tends to infinity, Sn minus 1 is equals to also L. Now observe that limit n tends to infinity, un can be written as, from this calculation you observe that Sn is equals to u1 plus u2 plus and so on plus un, and Sn minus 1 is equals to u1 plus u2 plus and so on plus un minus 1. You may calculate first Sn minus 1 is equals to very clearly un. Limit n tends to infinity un is equals to limit n tends to infinity Sn minus 1, which is nothing but limit n tends to infinity Sn minus limit n tends to infinity Sn minus 1, which is equals to L minus L, is equals to 0. Therefore, limit n tends to infinity un is equals to 0. Therefore, if summation un is convergent, then limit n tends to infinity un is equals to 0. This theorem is known as nth term test, and which is a necessary condition for a series to be convergent, but this is not sufficient. It means the converse of this theorem is not true. What is converse? Converse of this theorem is not true. What is converse? If limit n tends to infinity, un is equals to 0, then summation un need not be convergent. The converse of this theorem is, if limit n tends to infinity un is equals to 0, then summation un need not be convergent. Let us see one example. Take un is equals to 1 by root n. Then limit n tends to infinity un is equals to 1 by root n, whose value is equals to 0. Now write Sn is equals to, that is, let us write limit n tends to infinity un is equals to 0. Now write Sn is equals to u1 plus u2 plus and so on plus un, which is equals to 1 by root 1 plus 1 by root 2 plus and so on plus 1 by root n. which is greater than or equals to 1 by root 10 plus 1 by root 10 plus and so on plus 1 by root 10, which is greater than or equals to, which is greater than or equals to n by root 10, which is greater than or equals to root 10. Therefore, Sn greater than or equals to root 10, which tends to infinity as n tends to infinity. It means the nth partial sum is divergent. The nth partial sum is divergent. We know that if the nth partial sum is divergent, then the infinite series summation un is also divergent. Therefore, summation 1 by root n is divergent. 1 by root n is divergent. You observe that limit n tends to infinity un is equals to 0 implies as summation un is divergent. Therefore, the converse of this theorem is not true. If limit n tends to infinity un is equals to 0, then summation un need not be convergent. This example is also very, very important. And by using this condition, you can conclude one thing. And also, limit n tends to infinity, un is not equals to 0, then summation un is divergent. This is very, very important condition. From here, you will learn. Limit n tends to infinity, un is equals to 0, then very clearly the infinite series is divergent. Yes, observe that and practice nth term test and its converse and concentrate on the definition also. An infinite series is convergent if and only if its nth partial sum Sn is convergent. Infinite series is divergent if and only if its nth partial sum Sn is divergent. We use the same concept here. And observe that limit n tends to infinity un not equals to 0 implies summation un is divergent. In the next class, we solve some problems depends upon the nth term test and definition of the infinite series and definition of the convergence of infinite series.